In this video, you'll see how to deploy the AWS Quick Start for AWS Marketplace Serverless SaaS integration. With this automated reference deployment, you can easily integrate new software as a service or SaaS solutions on your AWS Marketplace seller account, accelerate the listing process, and significantly reduce go-to-market time. We'll begin on the AWS Marketplace Serverless SaaS Integration Quick Start page. Let's scroll down to the deployment instructions. The first step is to sign into our registered AWS Marketplace seller account. The second step is to launch the Quick Start. This brings us to the AWS CloudFormation console, where we'll create a stack to deploy the SaaS integration. The template source has been populated with the Amazon Simple Storage Service, or Amazon S3 URL, for this Quick Start, so we don't need to make any changes. Let's move on. Here we'll specify the stack details. Let's give our stack a custom name. Next, we'll choose the SaaS pricing model for our product. For this example, we'll use the Contracts with Subscriptions model. By default, the Quick Start deployment will create a page, hosted on Amazon CloudFront, for AWS Marketplace customers to register for our product. If we have a custom registration page, we can change the selection to False. In this case, we'll retain the default. We'll need an Amazon S3 bucket to host the registration page. We can either provide the name of an existing bucket or let the deployment create a new one for us. Next, we'll enter some information that AWS Marketplace provided at the time we published our SaaS product listing. We'll enter the product code and the subscription's SNS topic ARN. The Quick Start deployment also creates new tables in Amazon DynamoDB to aggregate the new subscribers and the metering records captured from our SaaS product listing on AWS Marketplace. Let's customize these table names. We'll also supply an administrator email address to accept SNS notifications related to the product. We'll leave the artifact S3 bucket name as the default. Let's proceed to the next step. Here we can review our stack configuration. For our purposes, we'll retain the default options. Let's move to the next step. Finally, we'll review our choices. Let's acknowledge the source requirements notice from AWS CloudFormation and create the stack. It takes a few minutes for the stack to be created. We can monitor its progress. Now that our stack has successfully been launched and deployed, we can complete the post-deployment steps. Let's return to the Quick Start page to view those steps in the deployment guide. First, we'll set up our registration page and connect it with the API gateway created by the stack. We can download the website files from here. We'll save the zipped files to our computer. Here's the extracted folder. Let's view the files. We'll open the script JavaScript file. Per the comment in the first line, we need to replace the placeholder value with the actual API gateway ID deployed in our stack. To find the ID, let's return to the CloudFormation console. We'll search the resources for the Serverless API. The physical ID link opens the API gateway console. We'll locate the appropriate API and copy its ID. Let's return to the script file and paste in the API ID. Let's save and exit the file. Now we'll upload the zipped files to the S3 bucket created by the stack. We can use this link to access the bucket that hosts the registration page. We'll drag and drop the files we want to add. Now we'll upload the files. The upload succeeded. Let's return to CloudFormation. Now we can establish the SaaS Fulfillment URL. Let's search for the CloudFront distribution created by the stack, as its domain is used for the registration URL. Here we can see the domain's physical ID. Next, let's go to the CloudFront console. We'll search for the same physical ID created by the integration stack. Let's copy the domain name and visit the registration page. As you can see, the registration token is missing. To complete page setup, we must contact the AWS Marketplace Seller Operations team and ask to have the domain name associated with our SaaS listing. As a final step, we'll want to confirm our Amazon SNS subscription by going to the admin email address we provided and selecting the subscription confirmation link that was sent when the stack was created. You've just seen how to deploy the AWS Quick Start for AWS Marketplace Serverless SaaS integration. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.